It always takes a couple seconds. Thank you all for coming to tonight's concert. A little abnormal for us to be playing on a Friday night. We normally do most of our concerts on Sunday afternoons, but we appreciate you all coming out tonight. I'm sure for most of you, you were just wandering across the street, and you were like, man, it's really cold inside, so let's see what's going on in here. And thank you for exploring the indoors with us. This is the University Wind Symphony. This is our only wind ensemble that we do in the fall semester. And this is our second concert of the season, so we are really looking forward to presenting the rest of our concert. That first piece was called Somno di Volare. It's from a video game called Civilization VI. I kind of did it for a couple different reasons. We have our video game music ensemble, which has been around for, oh gosh, probably I've been here six years. Probably closer to 8 years or so. And so that's kind of a head nod to the video game ensemble. It's a really nice arrangement. Also, it's one of my favorite video games. I'm not that big of a gamer, and don't have a lot of time for it anymore with the kids and everything, but Civilization is one of those video games that I've played since I was a little kid. And there's been six of them that have been released, and I've owned every one of them since Civilization 1 back in like the early 90s. So, and back then it was a lot simpler. It's a harder game now. But it also shows kind of the evolution of video game music. It has become a lot more symphonic, a lot more sophisticated. And so I wanted to kind of showcase that. The next piece we're gonna do is called One Life Beautiful, written by Julie Giroux. It's a really wonderful piece. Julie Giroux has written for movies and TV, and she also keeps her feet pretty square in the band world as well. So we're kind of fortunate to have that. So you'll hear this is also very orchestral kind of sound to it. But it is written for exclusively for the wind band. So this is One Life Beautiful.
Thank you.
next thing I'd like to do is invite Dr. Kyle Warnke up on stage just a moment. He is going to be doing with the band the Alfred Reed Russian Christmas music. You may think it's a little early for Christmas. No, it's not. Yes, Thanksgiving is first. But this is actually a piece Dr. Warnke took over for me last fall. I was on a family leave last fall, and Dr. Warnke took care of Wind Symphony while I was gone, and had planned on performing this piece with the Wind Symphony for the Christmas concert that year, but we had a little bit of a COVID scare, and we had to cancel that concert. And so I said, hey, why don't you do it with this group right now? So he did that, and we're really happy to do this piece. It's awesome work. So in just a moment, we'll bring on Dr. Kyle Warnke. normally wouldn't talk before I just kick them and I just come out on stage, but he'd explain a little bit about this next piece and also give the horns a chance to rest for a second. That's a demanding piece, that was excellent. So the next piece we're gonna do is called The Great Locomotive Chase by Robert W. Smith. I do quite a few of his pieces. We did one of his pieces earlier this semester. Usually every year or two I do a piece of Robert Smith's. This one I've always kind of enjoyed. It's a fun piece. It's one of those that's kind of quick and easy to put together. It's actually written for a middle school honor band, but it has a lot of really cool things in it. We have a lot of percussionists, a lot of percussion in it as well. And it actually tells a story. It actually has a little bit of a history connection to it. It actually tells the story of a chase of a locomotive in the Civil War. There were some Union soldiers down around Atlanta that confiscated a Confederate railroad car and basically started tearing down the tracks, I believe from Atlanta to Chattanooga, and started wreaking havoc and trying to disrupt the Confederate lines and kind of draw men away from Atlanta to have them chasing this train. They eventually did get caught somewhere along the way, and this is kind of the musical representation of that chase, the Great Locomotive Chase.
Thank you.
Of course, that the last piece was Semper Fidelis by John Philip Sousa, the official march of the United States Marine Corps. This being Veterans Day, I'd like to take a second. Is there anybody in the audience who served as a member of our armed forces? If you would please stand up. Please. Thank you all very much. Before we play our final piece, we do have one more piece of business that we have to get to. It is our custom for our last concert of the semester to recognize our graduating seniors. And being that it is the fall, we don't usually have many, but we have a couple of seniors who are graduating this semester. We want to take a moment to recognize them and thank them for their performances that they've given us over the years at S&T. The first one is in our horn section, Michael Sova. Michael is earning a degree in chemical engineering, and with the Wind Symphony, he's been performing with us for 7 semesters. And his future plan so far is to pursue a full-time job as a process engineer. So, Michael Sova. Next, in our bassoon section, we have Derek Holloway. Woo! Derek will be earning his degree in electrical engineering. He is also in his music career here. He has performed with the Wind Symphony for 7 semesters, the marching band for 3, the video game music ensemble for 7 semesters, and as you saw, he was also the director. He's been doing that for 5 semesters. A member of the movie music ensemble for 2 semesters, and he was also in the theater production of the last 5 years. Also, with the music program, I'm happy to say that he has earned a minor in music. A minor in music takes 15 credits in music, both in performing ensembles, but also in other coursework. And I've had the pleasure of having Derek in a number of my courses. And so to kind of recognize that for our graduating seniors who get our music minor, we give them each an honor chord. And it's pink because music is, the academic color of music is pink. So I want to award this to Derek at this moment. Our final piece for this evening is called Incantation and Dance by a composer, John Barnes Chance. Mr. Chance has a number of pieces that have become kind of standard in the wind band repertoire. We've performed a couple of them in the past. If you heard variations on a Korean folk song, we did that a number of years ago. That's one of his probably most well-known pieces. This is probably second or third of his well-known pieces. Mr. Chance passed away way too young. He had a lot more music to give, but unfortunately only left us a few pieces. And this, for my money, is probably my favorite piece of his. It's a very difficult piece that the group has done a tremendous job of preparing it. And so we hope you enjoy Incantation and Dance.